Hello everyone, in today's lecture we are going to discuss about the clipping circuits. Okay, so having discussed the basics of diode in the earlier class, today we are going to discuss about the clipping circuits. Primarily we are concerned with two varieties of circuits. One is series clippers. Okay, one is series clippers. Another is shunt clippers. Okay, another is shunt clippers. So these are the two types of clipping circuits that we will be studying from today onwards. Okay, so in either of these two kind of circuits we can observe the fundamental and simplest non-linear circuit element, that is the diode. Okay, so that is the reason why we have discussed the briefly regarding this diode. Okay, so this circuit is an example for series clipper for a reason. Okay, it all depends on that the position of my diode with respect to the load. So as my diode is in series with the load, this is said to be a series clipper. Unlike that, if I am drawing a circuit like this, okay, then my diode is coming in shunt with whatever the load I am having here, then I say that this is a shunt clipper. Okay, so these are the two varieties of clipping circuits that we will be focusing from now onwards. Okay, so one is series clippers, another is shunt clippers, right? Okay, before we go ahead with series clippers or shunt clippers, let me quickly give you the definition of clipping circuits. Okay, so here are the waveforms that are drawn for you. The dotted line is representing your input. Okay, the dotted line is representing your input, whereas this shaded line is representing your output. And you could see that I have considered a reference line. Okay, I have considered a reference line VR, so that I am trying to select the portion of the input signal which is above the reference level VR. You could observe here that I am taking the portion of the input signal which is above this reference level. Okay, right. When you look at this circuit, this waveform, okay, again I have taken the VR here. In this case VR is negative, in this case VR is positive, but nevertheless what I am trying to do is I am trying to select the portion of the input signal which is below the reference level. Okay, so whatever that is there below the reference level as my input signal, I am able to select that portion of the input signal. So selecting the portion of the input signal either above some reference level or below some reference level is what is said to be a clipping circuit. Okay, so sometimes these clipping circuits are also called as amplitude selectors or slicers. Okay, right. So is the definition of clipping circuits is okay? Either in this waveform or in this waveform, you could see that the output is nothing but selecting portion of the input signal below a reference level. Output is selecting the portion of the input signal above a reference level. Okay, right? Okay, so let us start with a basic circuit. Okay, which is a series clipping circuit. Okay, So the task given to us is, for this given circuit, first we need to plot the transfer characteristics. Transfer characteristics are nothing but plot between the input voltage and the output voltage. Okay, so relationship between the input and the output is what is representing your transfer characteristics. And we have to use this transfer characteristics for drawing the output response. Okay, so let this dotted line represent the input signal. Then we need to plot the output V naught, okay, making use of this transfer characteristics. So that is the task for almost all the clipper circuit that is given to us. Okay, finding the transfer characteristics, and using the transfer characteristics we are trying to plot the output response. Okay, and the procedure that we will be following is more or less same for almost all the circuits which involves the single diode in the circuit. Okay, right. And before we start, the assumption is that the diode is an ideal diode. Okay, before we start, that the assumption is diode is an ideal diode. What is that we know about the ideal diode? In an ideal diode, if the diode is forward biased, it can be replaced with a short circuit. Okay, if it is reverse biased, then it can be replaced with open circuit. Okay, right, fine. And we will be going ahead like this. So let us proceed like this. Let us assume diode is on. Diode is on means whenever diode is forward biased, okay, I used to replace that with short circuit. That is what I am calling it as on state. Okay, assume that diode is on, that is diode is operating in the forward bias region. Okay, then what is that I can do? I can replace my diode with a short circuit. Okay, I can replace my diode with a short circuit. This is my R across which I am taking my output. This is my input. Okay, so upon assumption that my diode is on, I have replaced my diode with short circuit. Then I need to find the current that is flowing through the diode in from P side to the N side, and that is being given in the question itself, represented as I. So I need to find I, which is the current through the diode from P side to the N side. If this I is positive, I know that my diode is forward biased. I say that diode is switched on. If I is negative, diode is reverse biased, diode is said to be switched off. Okay, right. Can you tell me what is my I is given by? I is given by Vi by capital R. Okay, now you tell me for what value of your Vi, okay, for what value of your Vi, my I is going to be positive, so that my diode is going to be forward biased. For my Vi is positive, whenever my Vi is positive, my I is positive. Okay, for my Vi is positive, my I is positive, my diode is on, then my output is given by, okay, whenever your diode is on, okay, it is replaced with short circuit. So that means my output voltage is same as my input voltage, because both are in the shunt. Okay, my output voltage is same as my input voltage when my diode is replaced with short circuit. So my output voltage is same as the input voltage. Okay, similarly for my Vi is negative, okay, for my Vi is negative, my I is less than 0, that means my diode is said to be off. Okay, my diode is said to be off. Whenever my diode is off, replace with open circuit. When I replace my diode with open circuit, what do I say about my output? Because no current is going to flow through the R, because it is an open circuit, my output voltage is 0. Okay, so my output voltage is 0. Is this okay? Right? So can I plot the transfer characteristics now? What is my transfer characteristic? For my Vi is greater than 0, that means positive. For all my input positive in this direction, my output is same as the input. For all my input negative, okay, my output is 0. Okay, so how do I plot the transfer characteristics? I'll be plotting my transfer characteristics as shown here. Okay, For all my input negative, my output is going to be negative. For my input positive, okay, my output is same as the input. This is what I would like to represent graphically, that my output is same as the input. If the slope is being 1, okay, if the slope is being 1, then what is my relation between output and the input? Output is same as the input, okay. So these are the transfer characteristics of this given circuit, okay. Now let us try to plot the response, okay, from this transfer characteristics, okay. So what are the transfer characteristics are telling us about? When will be my output is going to be 0 and when will be my output is same as the input. Look at here now. So my input is a dotted curve which is varying, which is a sinusoidal input signal, right? Though it can appear even for a negative time, but I am assuming that it is starting from t is equal to 0, right? So from this point of time to this point of time, my input is positive. Okay, whenever my input is positive, my output is same as the input. My output is same as the input. Okay, my output is same as the input. Right, my output is same as the input. But whenever my input is negative, whenever my input is negative, my output is 0. So my output is 0 in this region from this point of time to this point of time. My input is negative, thereby my output is 0. And from this point to this point, my input is positive. Whenever my input is positive, output has to follow the input. Okay, output has to follow the input, right? For my input negative, my output is 0. Okay, for input negative, my output is 0. For input positive, output needs to follow the input. For input negative, output is 0. Okay. So this is what is the output waveform, how it going to look like, okay, for this given circuit, okay. So the other name of this particular circuit is, okay, it is called as negative clipper, okay. The negative portion of your input signal has been clipped off, okay. So the other name for this circuit is a negative clipper, okay. The other name for this circuit is a negative clipper. Why negative clipper? Because the negative portion has been clipped off. Okay, what has been selected? Which portion of the input has been selected? Input, that portion of the input which is positive half cycle is selected, which is above a reference level, which is 0 in this particular case. Okay, so that is why it is called as a clipping circuit, and in particular you are calling it as a negative clipper. Okay, right, fine. Okay, so now let us consider another clipping circuit. Okay, in this case the diode has been reversed. Okay, earlier the diode is P side is here, N side is here, now it has been reversed. Okay, but the procedure remains same. Okay, we need to proceed for finding the transfer characteristics first, then we need to make use of the transfer characteristics in order to draw the output response. Okay, so how do we proceed? We'll start with an assumption that I'll assume my diode is on. Okay, I'll assume my diode is on. With the assumption that my diode is on, I can replace my diode with a short circuit. So I am replacing my diode with a short circuit. Okay, I am replacing my diode with a short circuit. Okay, so upon replacing my diode with short circuit, I need to find the current flowing through the diode. And what is the current direction now? My current direction is always from P side to the N side. If at all a current is flowing through the diode, it has to flow from P side to the N side. Okay, so that is why I have chosen that my current direction is in accordance to P side to N side. Now if this I is positive, my diode is forward biased. If this I is negative, my diode is reverse biased. Okay, can I find the expression for I? Yes, I can. Okay, I'll start from here. Okay, I into R, okay, plus VI plus VI is equal to 0. Okay, so that I is equal to minus VI by capital R. Okay, I is equal to minus VI by capital R. Now you tell me, for what value of input my I is going to be positive, so that my diode is going to be forward biased or in the on state. Okay, for what value of my VI my I is going to be negative, so that my diode is going to be reverse biased, that is in the off state. Okay, so when my VI is negative, okay, when my VI is negative, negative negative becomes positive, that is my I is going to be positive. When my I is positive, my diode is on. Okay, my diode is on. When my diode is on, nothing but you are replaced with short circuit, so that my output is same as my input. Okay, so my output is same as my input whenever my input is less than zero. Okay, similarly, whenever my input is greater than zero, that is positive. Okay, if my input is positive, positive into negative is negative, that means my I is negative. Whenever my current through the diode is negative, I say that diode is said to be reverse biased. That means diode is said to be in the off state. Okay, whenever my diode is off, off means you open circuit it. When you open circuit it, no current flows through your R, that means my output is going to be zero. Okay, my output is going to be zero, right? So with this information, let us try to plot the transfer characteristics. Okay, so what do you mean by transfer characteristics? Relationship between the input and the output. So whenever my input is negative, my output is same as the input. Whenever my input is positive, my output is zero. Okay, so let me draw the transfer characteristics. From here to up to infinity, okay, my input is positive. Whenever my input is positive, my output is zero. Okay, whenever my input is positive, my output is zero. Whenever my input is negative, okay, my output is same as the input. This is how I am representing the characteristic that my output is same as the input. My input is negative, my output is negative. Input is negative, output is negative. Okay, right? So now let us try to use this transfer characteristics for drawing the output response. Okay, let us use the transfer characteristics for drawing the output response. So this dotted line is representing your input VI, okay, varying with respect to time. Okay, or in between these two points, my input is positive. When my input is positive, my output is zero. Okay, that is from this point to this point, my output is zero. Whenever my input is positive, my output is zero. Whenever my input is negative, that is from this point, my input is negative. When my input is negative, my output has to follow the input, because my output is same as the input. Okay, because my output is same as the input, my output has to follow the input. Okay, when my input is positive, output has to be zero. When my input is negative, output has to follow the input. Okay, output has to follow the input. And when my input is positive, output has to be zero. When my input is negative, okay, output has to follow the input. Okay, so for my input positive, output has to be zero. For my input negative, output has to be same as the input. Okay, so this is what is called as your output voltage. Okay, what is that you are doing with the help of this circuit? You are trying to select the portion of the input signal which is below your reference level. Let it be 0 volts here. Okay, anything that is below 0, you are trying to select. Okay, so the entire portion of the input signal which is lying below the reference level, that is 0, you are trying to select. Okay, so for that reason, you can call this circuit as positive clipper. Okay, you can call this circuit as positive clipper. Why positive clipper? Why positive clipper? Because positive halves of your input signal have been clipped off. Okay, positive halves of your input signal have been clipped off. That is why it is positive clipper. Earlier circuit I called it as a negative clipper. Now this circuit is called as positive clipper. Okay, is this okay? Fine. Okay, so let us consider this circuit. Okay, where we are considering a reference voltage VR. Okay, unlike the earlier case where you could not find any reference voltage VR, but now you could see a reference voltage VR, but otherwise everything is same. Okay, so again our targets are plotting the transfer characteristics and making use of it for drawing the output response. Okay, right. So let us start with assuming that your diode is on. Okay, assuming that your diode is on. So upon assumption of your diode on, replace your diode with short circuit. So I am replacing my diode with short circuit. Right. Okay. So upon replacing my diode with short circuit, I need to find the current flowing through the diode and in which direction my current flows through the diodes, always from P side to the N side. Let it be denoted with I. Now you just find out I. If I is positive, okay, your diode is forward biased, that is in the on state. If I is negative, your diode will be in the reverse bias, that is your diode is in the off state. Okay. So can you write an equation for my I? Yes, I can. Okay. So I'll start from here. Okay. Minus VR. Okay. Plus I into R plus VI is equal to 0. Applying KVL. Okay. So apply KVL in this direction. Okay. So minus VR plus I into R plus VI is equal to 0. From which I can write my I is equal to, what is my I? I is equal to, I can write this VI is going to become minus VI, this VR is going to become plus VR. Okay. So I am writing like this, minus VI minus VR. Okay. Divided by R. Is this okay? I can write my I as minus of VI minus VR by R. Okay. Why? Because this VI is going to become minus VI. This minus VR is going to become plus VR when I bring it onto the right hand side. So plus VR. Okay. Now you tell me, for what condition that your I is going to be positive, for what condition your I is going to be negative. Okay. So whenever my VI is, okay, whenever my VI is less than VR, okay, whenever my VI is less than VR, so that means the term inside the brackets, okay, the term inside the brackets is less than 0, that means negative. Negative into negative becomes positive. That means my I is going to be positive, okay, for my VI is less than VR. Okay, for my VI is less than VR, my I is going to be positive. Whenever my I is positive, my diode is going to be on. When my diode is on the short circuit, my output voltage is same as the input voltage. Okay, so my output is same as the input voltage. Okay, my output is same as the input voltage. Is this okay? Right. So for what condition that your I is going to be negative? The term which is inside the bracket, if it is positive, positive into negative is negative. So that means my VI is greater than VR. Positive means greater than 0. Then my VI is going to be greater than VR. Okay. Then I say that my I is negative, because positive into negative is negative. Whenever my I is negative, my diode is going to be off. My diode is going to be off. Whenever my diode is off, that means open circuit. Okay. So when your diode is open circuit, no current flows through your R. Okay. So when you take your output voltage from these two points, okay, in between these two points, what you are taking your output. So when there is no current through this R, drop across this R is 0, so that my output voltage from this point to this point is Vr itself. Okay, so my output is going to be Vr itself. Okay, my output is going to be Vr itself. It is okay, right? So with this information, let us try to plot the transfer characteristics. Okay, your output is dependent on whether your Vi is less than Vr or Vi is greater than Vr. So that means firstly we need to look at where is my Vr is. As your Vr is positive here, I locate my Vr somewhere here. Okay, I locate my Vr somewhere here. When my Vr is here, okay, maybe my output where it is having a value of Vr is also here. Okay, let us say Vr is equal to 5 volts. Okay, on the x-axis if my 5 volts is here, on the y-axis your 5 volts may be somewhere here. Okay, right. So now for my Vi is greater than Vr, my output is Vr. For my Vi is greater than Vr, for all my input signal greater than Vr, my output is given as Vr only. Okay, for all my input greater than Vr, that is from this point towards the infinity, okay, my output is being given by Vr. Okay, but for my Vi is less than Vr, okay, my output is same as the input. How do I represent that my output is same as the input? My output is same as input is being represented graphically like this. Okay, for all my input less than Vr, my output is same as the input. Okay, so this is what is the transfer characteristic of the given circuit. Okay, right. So let us use this transfer characteristic. Okay, let us use this transfer characteristic for plotting the output response. Okay, so my input is, let us say, this dotted curve, okay, varying with respect to time variable t. Let us assume that it is starting from t is equal to 0, right? Then you need to locate your Vr so that you can easily know what is your output depending upon whether your Vi is greater than Vr or Vi is less than Vr. Okay, so I'll be locating my Vr somewhere here. Okay, I'll be locating my Vr somewhere here. Okay, let us assume that this is what is my Vr is. Okay, I have drawn a line so that that line is representing my reference level, that is Vr. Now when I am moving from this point to this point, okay, my input voltage is less than this Vr. Whenever my Vi is less than Vr, okay, my output is same as the input. Okay, my output is same as the input. So that means from here to here, okay, from here to here, my output is same as the input. But from this point to this point, my input is greater than Vr. Whenever my input is greater than Vr, my output is same as Vr. And my Vr line has been drawn here so that my output is going to be same as Vr. Okay. And from this point to this point, my input is less than Vr. Whenever my input is less than Vr, my output is same as input. So my output has to follow the input over this particular duration. Okay, and over this duration my input is greater than Vr. Okay, over this duration my input is greater than Vr. This is what is my input. Okay, so which is greater than Vr. Okay, over that duration my output is likely to be Vr itself. So my output is going to be Vr itself. But from this point to this point, okay, your input is going to be less than your Vr. Whenever your input is less than Vr, okay, then your output has to follow your input. So my output has to follow my input. Okay, and for my input greater than Vr, okay, for my input greater than Vr, my output has to be same as my Vr itself. My output has to be same as my Vr itself. When my input is less than Vr, then my output has to be follow the input. Okay, my output has to follow the input. okay, right? So this particular curve is called as your V naught. Okay, so what this circuit is doing is, this circuit is selecting the portion of the input which is below this so-called reference level VR. Earlier the reference level is 0, but now the reference level is not 0, it is somewhat more than 0. Okay, right, fine. Let us consider one more circuit where the circuit is being shown like this. Again, our task is to find the transfer characteristics here, and using the transfer characteristics, I need to find the output response. Okay, so let us start. Assume my diode is on. Okay, assume that my diode is on. So upon assumption of that my diode is on, replace your diode with a short circuit. Okay, replace your diode with a short circuit. Okay, I have replaced my diode with short circuit. So now I need to find out the current flowing through the diode. Okay, so I know that my current always flows from the P side to the N side of my diode. So my current direction is like this. So if my I is positive, my diode is forward biased, that is in the on state. If my I is negative, my diode is reverse biased, that is in the off state. Okay, so can I write an expression for my I? Yes, I can. Okay, apply the KVL. Okay, I into R, I can write here I into R, applying KVL, okay, I into R plus VR, okay, plus VR minus VI is equal to 0. Okay, now what is my I can be written as? I can be written as, when this minus VI brought onto the right side, it is going to become plus VI. When this plus VR is brought onto the right side, it is going to become minus VR. So my I is given by, okay, VI minus VR divided by capital R. Okay, my I is given as VI minus VR by capital R. Now you tell me, when will my I is going to be positive? For what condition of my VI, my I is going to be positive? For my VI is greater than VR, okay, when my VI is greater than VR, this entire term is going to be positive. So that is, my I is going to be positive. Okay, so whenever my I is positive, I know that my diode is going to be on. When my diode is on, okay, I can replace my diode with short circuit, then my output voltage is same as my input voltage. Okay, so my output voltage is same as my input voltage. Is this okay? Right. When my VI is less than VR, okay, when my VI is less than VR, my I is less than 0. Okay, this I is nothing but the current through the diode. If it is negative, I know that my diode is off. Okay, so when my diode is off, that means open circuit, no current flows through R, then my output voltage is given by from these two points. Okay, so my output is always given from these two points. When the drop across this is 0, then my output voltage is same as my VR. Okay, so my output voltage is same as my VR. Okay, so let us use this particular information for drawing the transfer characteristics. As you can understand, that your output is dependent on whether your VI is greater than VR or VI is less than VR. So we need to locate here, where is my VR is. As my VR is positive here, I can locate my VR as somewhere here. Okay. So what is that it is telling is, when my VI is less than VR, my output is same as VR. Okay. So let us locate my VR on the output side also. Then for all my input, for all my input less than VR, my output is same as the VR. Okay, for all my input less than VR, my output is same as the VR. When my VI is greater than VR, okay, then my output is same as the input. How do I represent my output is same as the input? This is how I represent my output is same as the input. Okay, right? So these are the transfer characteristics, so that what we get from this particular circuit. Okay, so let us try to use this transfer characteristics for drawing the output response. Okay. So this dotted line, okay, this dotted line is representing your input varying as a function of time. Assume that it starts at 0, right? But your output normally depends on, okay, your reference level, that is VR. Okay, so I am drawing a reference level, that is VR. So let my reference level be denoted with VR. So now you just observe that whether your input is greater than VR or less than VR. If your input is greater than VR, your output is defined in one way. If your input is less than VR, then your output is defined in another way. Okay. So when my VI is less than VR, output is same as the VR. So that is from this point to this point. Okay. My input is less than VR. Whenever my input is less than VR, it is being denoted by VR itself. Okay. So it is being denoted by VR itself. Okay, this is what is my output is. And whenever my input is greater than VR, okay, whenever my input is greater than VR, my output is same as the input. Okay, my output is same as the input. And when my input is less than VR, output is same as the VR. Okay, output is same as the VR. When my input is greater than VR, then my output is same as the input. When my input is less than VR, output is same as the VR. And when my input is greater than VR, output is same as the input. Okay. So this circuit is going to select the portion of the input which is above this reference voltage, that is VR. Okay. So this is called as, okay, this is called as your output voltage. Okay, this is your output voltage, right? Is this okay? Right? Fine. Okay. Let us consider this circuit. This time VR is considered as a negative. Okay, so the battery here is represented with a negative symbol. Okay, again as usual, same, we are interested to find the transfer characteristics, that is a relationship between input voltage and the output voltage, and we need to make use of this transfer characteristics for drawing the output response. Okay, so let us start with assuming that my diode is on. Okay, assuming that my diode is on, so with the assumption that my diode is on, I can replace my diode with a short circuit. Okay, I can replace my diode with a short circuit. Okay, so I have replaced my diode with short circuit. Now I need to find the current flowing through the diode. I assume that current is always from the P side to the N side. Let it be denoted with I. So if this I is positive, my diode is forward biased, that is in the on state. If this I is negative, my diode is reverse biased, that is in the off state. Okay. So can I write an expression for my I? Yes, I can. Apply the KVL. What do that I get when I apply the KVL? I into R. Okay. Minus VR. Okay. Minus VI is equal to 0. What is that I can write for my I? I is equal to, when this minus I is brought to the right hand side, it is plus VI. When this minus VR is brought onto the right hand side, it is plus VR. Okay. So my I can be written as VI plus VR. Okay. VI plus VR by R. Okay. right? So this I can write it as, okay, this I can write it as minus of minus VR. Okay, both are same, minus into minus is plus, right? So now can you tell me when your I is going to be positive, so that your diode is going to be forward biased or in the on state? For my VI is greater than minus VR, then you say that your I is going to be positive. Okay, so I am writing here, when my VI is greater than minus VR, okay, suppose if VR is 5, okay, then VI is greater than minus 5 means minus 4, minus 3, minus 2. For all VI minus 4, minus 3, minus 2 and so on, your VI is greater than minus VR. Okay, so whenever my VI is greater than minus VR, I is positive. So when my I is positive, okay, my diode is on. When my diode is on, my output is given by, when my diode is on, short circuited, output is same as the input. Okay, my output is same as the input. Okay, similarly when my VI is less than minus VR, okay, when my VI is less than minus VR, then my I is negative. Okay, then my I is negative and my diode is going to be off. When my diode is off, open circuit, when open circuit, no current flows through there, then my output from here to here is given by same as your VR. Okay, same as your VR. But what is VR here is a negative number. Okay, VR is a negative number. This VR may be positive. Okay, but because the battery is represented in the negative way, okay, I'll call this VR as a negative. Okay, see, either you write it this VR as a positive, then the battery is a negative. If the battery is represented with plus sign and minus sign, and if you write this VR as minus VR, then also it is negative battery representation. Okay, either way it is right. Okay, fine. So now let us try to use this information for drawing the transfer characteristics. Okay, when my VI is greater than minus VR, output is same as input. When my VI is less than minus VR, output is equal to VR. Okay, right. So now I need to locate my VR first, because my output is dependent on whether my VI is greater than VR or VI is less than VR. And as this is minus VR, where it can be minus VR? Okay, so my minus VR can be somewhere here, yes or no? I am writing it as plus VR, but because it is in to the left side of the zero, it is a minus VR. Okay, similarly from the output point of view, where my minus VR can be? Below your zero axis. Okay, right. Okay, so when my VI is less than minus VR, my minus VR is somewhere here. When my VI is less than minus VR, suppose if this is 5, VR is 5, that means I am at minus 5. So VI is less than minus 5 means I have to go in this direction. Okay, I have to go in this direction. So for all these values of VI, VI is less than V minus VR, okay, what is my output is same as VR. Okay, my output is same as VR. Okay, for all my input less than VR, this is VR is negative. Suppose if the VR is 5 volts, okay, so minus 5, any input less than minus 5 is minus 6, minus 7 and so on. So that is why for all these values of VI, my output is VR. When my VI is greater than minus VR, so that means for input values greater than this minus 5, that is minus 4, minus 3, 2, 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on, my output is equal to input. So how do I represent my output is equal to input? How do I represent? I'll represent like this. Okay, I'll represent like this. Okay, this is my V naught. Okay, so this is what the transfer characteristics are going to look like. Okay, so for my VI greater than minus VR, V naught is equal to VI. For VI is less than minus VR, V naught is equal to less VR. Okay, so now let us try to plot the output response. Okay, now let us try to plot the output response. Okay, so from this point, okay, from this point onwards, or you need to locate first your reference voltage. Where is my reference voltage? Is my reference voltage is somewhere here, okay, because it is a negative, I'm drawing a line in the negative axis. Okay, so my VR is now here because it is negative. You just observe that whether your input is greater than VR or less than VR. Okay, your input is greater than minus VR. Okay, output is same as input. So when I am here, okay, is it not greater than VR? Greater than minus VR. Okay, then my output is same as input. My output is same as the input. Okay, up to this point, from this point to this point, my input is greater than this VR level, so my output is same as the input. When my input is less than minus VR, okay, when my input is less than minus VR, okay, right, then my output is going to be same as VR. Okay, then my output is going to be same as VR. Whenever my input is greater than minus VR, output is same as input. So output is same as input. When my input is less than VR, output is same as the VR. When my input is greater than minus VR, output is same as the input. Okay, right. So this is what is represented with your V naught. Okay, is this okay? Right. Fine. Okay, let us consider the last circuit. In the case of these series clippers, okay. So in this case, the circuit is being shown like this. So we were asked to draw the transfer characteristics. By using the transfer characteristics, we need to plot the output response. Okay. So let's begin. Assume your diode is on. Okay. Assume your diode is on. Upon assumption that your diode is on, I can replace my diode with a short circuit. Okay. Okay. So I have replaced my diode with short circuit. Now I need to find the current that is flowing through the diode. I know that current through the diode is always from P side to the N side. Okay. So let us denote that with I. If this I is positive, diode is forward biased in the on state. If I is negative, diode is reverse biased, diode will be in the off state. Okay. So can I find an expression for my I? Yes, I can. Apply the KVL. Okay. So when I apply the KVL in this particular loop, okay, I can write it as VR, okay, VR plus I into capital R plus VI is equal to 0. Okay, so from this, what is that I can write for I? I is equal to, okay, I is equal to minus VI minus VR. Okay, so I will be writing, okay, minus of VI plus VR by R. Okay, so I can write that minus of VI plus VR by R. Okay, right. Again, for convenience, okay, I am writing like this. Okay, both are same. Minus into minus is plus, so minus of VI plus VR by R. Okay, now you tell me when will be my I is positive, when will be my I is negative. Whenever my VI is greater than minus VR, okay, my I is going to be negative. Whenever my VI is less than minus VR, my I is going to be positive. Okay. Right, so I can write it as like this. When my Vi is greater than minus Vr, okay, Vi is greater than minus Vr, that means term within the brackets is positive, then positive into negative is negative, that means my I is negative. When your I is negative, diode is off, okay, diode is off. When your diode is off, okay, you can say that no current flows through your R, so that my output voltage from here to here is same as your Vr, okay. So my output voltage is same as Vr, okay. My output voltage is same as Vr, okay. My output voltage is same as Vr. Similarly, when my Vi is less than minus Vr, okay, when my Vi is less than minus Vr, Vi is less than minus Vr means this term within the brackets is negative, negative into negative positive, my I is going to be positive. Whenever my I is positive, my diode is said to be on. When my diode is on, short circuit, okay, so my output is same as my input, okay, so my output is same as my input, okay, my output is same as my input. So let us try to use this information for plotting the transfer characteristics, okay. So I need to plot, first identify where is my Vr is. As my Vr is negative, okay, let me locate my Vr on both input side as well as on the output side, okay. So whenever my Vi is greater than minus Vr, okay, output is same as Vr. Vi is greater than minus Vr, let us say Vr is equal to 5, that means I am at minus 5. My Vi is greater than minus 5 means minus 4, minus 3 and so on. So that means for all these input values which are greater than this minus 5, for example, then my output is same as the input, same as the Vr, okay. So that means from here onwards, okay, for all values of input greater than this Vr, my output is going to be Vr only, okay. For all my input greater than this Vr, my output is going to be Vr, right. For my Vi is, okay, for my Vi is less than minus Vr, Vi is less than minus, for example, Vr is 5, then I am at minus 5. All the input less than minus 5, minus 6, minus 7 and so on, up to minus infinity. What is my output is given by? Same as the input. How do I represent that my output is same as the input? Okay. So this is how I represent that my output is same as the input. Okay. So let us try to use this transfer characteristics for drawing the output response. Okay. So this dotted line is representing my input signal. Okay. Starting at 0 for assumption. And it is a variable of time. And now I need to locate my reference level. Let us assume that this is my reference level. Okay. This is my reference level. Okay. Whenever my input is greater than minus Vr, output is same as Vr. From here to here, what is my input is greater than Vr or minus Vr? My output is same as the Vr. So my output is same as the Vr for all my input when it is greater than Vr. When my input is less than minus Vr, my output is same as the input. My output is same as the input when my input is less than minus Vr. Okay. When my input is greater than minus Vr, my output is same as the Vr. When my input is less than minus Vr, output is same as the input. So my output is supposed to be following the input. And for all my input greater than Vr, my output has to be same as Vr. And for my input less than minus Vr, my output has to follow the input. And so on. Okay. So this is how, okay. So this is how your output is likely to look like. Okay. So this is your output voltage. Okay. So with this, we will be winding up this series clippers. From the next class onwards, we'll look at the shunt clippers. Okay. So thank you all for watching. See you next.